Hey everybody. So a big topic of interest here in Canada is medical and marijuana and how the system works with the government. So since 2001, this system has been in place, whereas under the MMAR, whatever that means, people who are classified as Category 1 can apply to relieve symptoms of these diseases. So only these diseases count really if you want medical marijuana. It's cancer, multiple sclerosis, HIV and AIDS infections, spinal cord injuries or disease, and severe forms are arthritis. Cancer, I believe, because pot slows down the spread of those cells, I think, in your body. Whereas for spinal cord injuries or arthritis, it's mostly, I think, because it relieves the pain a little bit because of what marijuana does, basically, I think. People who have seizures caused by epilepsy, I believe, can get it as well. And okay, so you know, you're only allowed to have 1 to 5 grams on you. If you guys don't know what a gram is, you're an idiot. And basically, that's as much as you're typically allowed to have. Now, here's what you can be authorized. So you're allowed to do this if given permission. You can obviously possess it. You can grow it yourself and possess it. And you can have your designated producer. Basically, you can have a drug dealer that you get your shit from, as long as the head's okay. That's gonna be kind of weird to, hey, so I know this guy who sells marijuana. Oh, what's his name? And where does he live? And what's his phone number? It's like, I don't wanna, you know what? That's not a good, you no. Never mind. I don't know anyone who sells marijuana. but here are basically the ideas for changing it are basically eliminate the categories, conditions, and symptoms that you would require. So basically anyone can apply for it. Doctors give it directly, other than going through the actual the government of Ontario. And allow it to grow itself. Allow that other patients to grow their own marijuana or designate grower instead. Okay, so instead of you being able to grow it yourself, the Health Canada will license actual suppliers in like areas, basically drug dealers. But because they're for the government, A-okay, right? It's fucking stupid. Now here is what I'm going to say. And I say a lot of controversial shit on this 7-episode show so far. So people might think I'm an asshole, people might think I'm not. One, I don't smoke marijuana. I don't do drugs at all. And if you don't consider marijuana a drug, then honestly I think you're stupid, but it's fair enough. Everyone's been wanting this change for an extremely long time. Obviously I don't see the appeal in it because I've never done marijuana, I don't plan to, but from what I know and from what research I've done on marijuana, specifically for like school projects and super shit like that, the other kids are like, "Yeah, we should do marijuana, man. Like, it doesn't even hurt. It doesn't even like do anything, man." And I'm like, "No, you can get smoke inhalation in your lungs. It's actually really bad for you. Like, any smoke is bad for you." So I don't see where you're coming from with that. But basically, what I'm trying to say is, why has it taken so long for the government to try and implement something in general? Why don't you give it 2 months, or a month even, if you're really that worried, of people just allowed to smoke pot for a month? 1 month. Allow people to smoke pot in like, not, it doesn't have to be all across Canada. It could be only in Ontario, only in Montreal. I know a lot of people who like it in Montreal, only in Vancouver, like places like that. And then if it doesn't work out, obviously you'll take it back after that period's over, and you'll see what's transpired. And if somehow marijuana has caused some great crash of the stock market, which I'm pretty sure it actually helped the stock market a lot, so invest in marijuana when you can, because it's going to be free eventually. Unless marijuana causes the next world disaster, I don't see the problem with it. It is classified as a drug, but if it's really that bad for you, then I don't think the government has the right to sell it more than a person on the street does. I think that's literally hypocritical, but then again, it is the government. What the fuck do you expect? I'm Brandon Cohen. This isn't really the circle, so I don't know why I'm saying this, but this is my stance on marijuana.